Okay, we look at this example. We try this example. A ladder of 10 feet long rests against a vertical wall. And if the bottom of the ladder slides away from the wall at a rate of 1 feet per second, how fast is the top of the ladder sliding down from the wall when the bottom of the ladder is 6 feet from the wall? Okay, for this question, it's better if we draw a diagram, a figure. Okay, let's say this is the wall. Okay, and this would be the floor. Okay, and we have a 10 feet ladder. Let's say this is the 10 feet ladder. Okay, just imagining it. Okay, this is 10 feet. Okay, and then given to us, if the bottom of the ladder here slides away, the rate of change will be 1 feet per second. So we will label this as y, this as x. That means here, dx dt is equal to 1 feet per second. The value here would be positive because the value of x would increase. Okay, we want to find how fast is the top of the ladder sliding down. That means we just want to find the dy dt. Dy dt is equal to y. Okay, of the ladder is when the ladder is 6 feet from the wall. Okay, that means given here, x is equal to 6. Okay, so let's solve this question. Okay, we have two ways to solve this question. First is using chain rule and the second one is implicit differentiation. Okay, let us use chain rule first. We have actually, we know that we want to determine dy dt, which means we want to determine dy over something. The chain rule would be like this. Okay, since we know the value of dx dt, therefore substitute dx here. Okay, so that when we cancel dx and dx, we will have dy over dt. As you can see from this figure, we can actually sort of build an equation using theorem of Pythagoras. Okay, using Pythagoras theorem. Okay, we will have actually an equation of x squared plus y squared equal to 10 squared, which means y is can be simplified into y equal to root of 100 minus x squared, which can also be written as y equal to 100 minus x squared power of half. Okay, next, determine dy over dx. That means we differentiate y with respect to x. Bring the power forward, differentiate inside the bracket, rewrite the function. The power subtract by 1, simplify whatever that can be simplified. So we have dy dx is equal to negative x, 100 minus x squared. Okay, here will be root of 100 minus x squared. Okay, therefore we can actually calculate for dy dt when x is equal to 6 feet. We have actually dy dx here, negative x. You might want to write this first, negative x times 100 minus x squared times 1. Okay, calculate for the value for dy dt, we will have negative 6 over root of 100 minus 6 squared, which is negative 3 over 4 feet per second. Okay, the unit is feet per second because the value of y over the rate of change of the value of y. Okay, okay, next, for implicit differentiation, okay. It will be the same figure, okay, and we will be utilizing the Pythagoras theorem again, which is x squared plus y squared equal to 100, okay. From here, we want to find actually is, we actually want to determine dy over dt. Okay, what we can do is differentiate both sides with respect to t, okay, equal to d over dt. 100. Okay, and here differentiate x squared will be 2x, but the unknown is different. That means we need to add dx over dt plus differentiate y squared is 2y, and then the unknown different 2. That's why we need to add dy over dt. Differentiate 100 would be equal to 0. Okay, from here we can actually determine dy dt, but as you can see, we need the value of y. Okay, therefore we need to calculate the value of y. Okay, using this equation actually, you can find the value of y. Y is equal to root of 100 minus 6 squared, which is 8 feet. Okay, therefore 2 times 6 times dx dt, which is 1, plus 2 times 8 dy dt is equal to 0. Rearrange and simplify, you will have dy dt equal to 2 times 6 is 12, okay, negative 12 over 2 times 8 is 16. Okay, simplify this value, this rational, you will have negative 3 over 4, 2. Okay, the same answer. Negative 3 over 4 feet over second. Okay, the answer are, okay, we have the same answer. So either way, if you want to use the chain rule, also possible, and it is also possible to use implicit differentiation to solve this problem. Thank you.